Okay, hi all. Welcome to the next session of microcontroller and embedded system laboratory. Today we're going to discuss about the next part A experiment, that is 7th experiment, write program to arrange a series of 32 bit and number in ascending or in descending order. Okay, so first we'll discuss about ascending order, then exactly opposite you can go for the ascending order. Okay, now look at the which algorithm or method you can adopt to sort the numbers either in ascending or in descending order. Okay, now problem is that so which sorting method we can adopt it, because there are many sorting techniques are there, bubble sort, selection sort, merge sort, the many techniques are there, but more widely adopted is bubble sort, because easy to write, because in the program program aim does not mention about particular any sorting methods, so that's why better I preferably use bubble sort. Okay, bubble sort is the simplest simple algorithm which repeatedly swapping the adjacent element if they are in wrong order. They'll repeatedly swap it if they are in not in correct order, then only swap it. If it is correct order, no need of swapping it. Okay, so what is the swapping meaning, we'll discuss with the help of one example. Okay, here now these are few numbers are there, I'm going to arrange it in the ascending order. Now here, before start working on bubble sort, you must know the how many numbers you want to sort it, either in ascending or descending order. In this example, I am sorting the 5 numbers. Okay, you can take any other numbers, 2 number, 3, 4 or more than that also. Okay, now how to these numbers are sorted, because as in the definition says that it repeatedly swap it if they are arranged in the wrong order. Repeatedly means how many times you have to repeat it. Okay, here I shown the repetition, or instead of I use the word as a pass also you can say that, or first repetition also you can say that. Okay, here repetition is 1, 2, 3, and 4. Okay, to sort 5 numbers we need the four repetitions are required. Okay, that is number of elements minus 1, that many number of we need the repetition. Okay, that is repetition. But how many swap, when we need to swap it, after comparing only we can able to swap it, whether they are in arranged correct order or not. If it is or a wrong order, then only we have to swap it. Okay, nothing but we need to compare it, then only we can take the decision to whether I have to swap or not. Now look at these numbers now, 5, 1, 4, 2, 8. Okay, these are my numbers, I mentioned it. So first I'll compare these two now. Okay, after comparing 5 and 1, so I'll know that 1 is less than 5, so swap 1 and 5. So after that we'll get these numbers, that is 1, 5, 4, 2, 8. So still we need to compare remaining numbers. Okay, now next I'll compare 5 with 1. Nothing but the first element is comparing with the second element. Okay, similarly second element, now I am comparing with the third element. Here you can observe, I'll compare now 5 and 4. Okay, as 4 is less than the 5, so swap it. So now arrangement is, now numbers are arranged in 1, 4, 5, 2, 8. Okay, similarly now I'll compare the third and fourth element. Again I'll swap it, as 2 is less than 5. So now next order is, now numbers are ordered as 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Next after that I'll compare the fourth and fifth element. Again I'll there is no need of swap, because 5 is already less than 8. Okay, now the after the first pass or first repetition, after comparing and I'm swapping, we'll got the next order, it is 1, 4, 2, 5, 8. Okay, looking at this number, it's still is not correctly ordered or ascending order, so need one more pass or one more repetition where we'll compare it again. Again, we swap it. Okay. Now, in the first pass, we can observe how many comparison I done it. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, 4 comparisons you have done it. Okay. Now here, in second pass, how many comparisons are required? Of course, 4 minus 1 comparisons are required. Okay, that is 3 comparisons. 1, 4, then 4, 2, and 4, 5. Okay, here in this 1, 4 does not require swap. 4, 2 required swap because 2 is less than 4. So I'll arrange it. Then 4, 5 does not require swap. Okay, so it need 3 comparisons are required. Okay, only 3 numbers we're going to compare. Okay, then next one is the in the third pass. Well, how many comparisons are required now? 3 minus 1. Only 2 comparisons. Okay. Here 1, 2 will compare it, then 2, 4 will compare it. Okay. After comparison, you can observe that there is no need of swapping. Then last pass, only will compare the first 2. So how many comparisons are required? 2 minus 1. Okay, that is 1 comparison is required. Okay. Now reason for number of comparison goes on reducing. Reason is that the answer is in the definition. It says what it says, repeatedly swapped. It says that it's mentioned that in that repeatedly. Repeatedly means how many times you are going to repeat it. Okay. Unnecessary repetition is no useful, otherwise your program goes unnecessary in the infinite loop. Okay. To overcome this problem, okay, as 5 elements are there, total how many number of repetitions are required? 5 minus 1, 4 repetitions are within 4 repetition, or repeatedly comparing and arranging it 4 times are required. In each repetition, how many comparisons are required? Okay, in first repetition or first pass, we need the only 4 comparisons. In this first one, 4 comparison, second we need 3, and third we need 2, and last one need 1. Okay, nothing but till your number of elements or number of total repetition becomes 0, then you have to stop the arrangement or stop the repetition or stop the swapping. Okay, so to write this program, so we need the how many number of elements. For example, we need how many number of variables are required. So we need variable which holds your count. So count, then one variable which holds your array. You can give any other name also, no problem. Only always is not that array also. Okay, you can give the name as list also. Then count and array. So any other variable is required? No other variables are required, because we are going to swap in the same array only itself. We are not creating another new array. Okay, the same array itself. Okay, so this count is in, we can keep it in the, in case of LPC 2148, we can keep it in ROM or ROM memory, and array we can, of course, in both we need read also, right? We can keep it in the RAM. Okay, then which are register you're going to use it? Okay, so I'll count and keep it in R0, and how many number of comparisons are required, that is this number I'll keep it in the R1. Okay, not only in R1 also, I'll need to keep it in the R0 also, because every after each pass I need to decrement the R0 by 1, because how many repetitions are required, that we need to keep the track. Okay, how many total repetition, R1 will keep how many comparisons are required, how many times you have to compare each adjacent element. So if swap is required or not based on their wrong order. Okay, now this comparison kept track by R1, and the total repetition kept by the R0. Okay, so in simple word, total iteration nothing but outer iteration or outer repetition. That will keep the how many times you have traced all the complete elements, you have passed through all the elements till they get arranged it. Okay, R1 will keep that in each pass how many comparisons are required. Okay, then these are about the inner counter and outer counter. Inner counter is here R1, this we can say that inner counter, or for inner iteration we can say that this is for outer R0. Okay. Then after that we need one more pointer to access the elements of the array. Okay, for we can use the R2 to access the element. Okay, R2 holds the address of first element. For example, here it is holds the 5. Now that 5 you want to compare with the next element. Of course, R2 we need to increment by 4 if you are working with the 32-bit number. If you are working with 16-bit number, increment by 2. If it is 1 byte, no need of 1, only 1 increment is required. Okay, now where most of our program are working on the 32-bit, so increment it by 4 or only add 4 into that. Okay, now we'll go to your program part, so we'll come to know that. So we're going to resolve it. Okay, now before going to actual program, I hope you remember your sixth program to find the smallest or largest number. Now this program is for to find the largest number. Okay, what we have done here, I'll start from this part only. What we have done it, we have compared the two numbers, which one is in R3, another is in the R4. Okay, sorry, R3. One is in R2, another is in the R3. After comparison, if the R2 content is already larger than R3, no need to change here. If it is less than, so we'll copy the content of R3 into the R2. Okay, here in case of bubble sort, instead of copying it, we'll interchange the content or exchange the content of R2 and R3. Okay, nothing but two elements we need to swap in the array. Okay, we need to swap it. Okay, so how we can swap it? Here we are not swapping in inside the register, we are swapping into the memory, which is pointed by register R2. Okay, now I'll start with the program. Okay, now here, so already had declared the two variables, one variable already in the ROM, and next variable is your series. I am array, instead of using name as array, I am using the variable name as series, and where I wrote space 20. Okay, so we'll think of that. You could have declared the numbers, five numbers. Yes, correct, I could have declared it, but in LPC 2148 the major problem is that, or the Kyle compiler from the RAM, if you wrote in the program predefined numbers from the RAM, we can't not able to read it. That is the main problem in the Kyle compiler. To overcome, we can enter the values in the manual in the RAM during execution. So I'll demonstrate that one. Okay, now we can start with the program now. So as I said that R0 will keep the outer counter, R1 is outer inner counter comparison, then R2 is acts as a pointer. Now we can start writing the program. So we'll load the R0 with the count. Okay, nothing but the 5 is copied into the R0. Now that is subtracted by 1. Okay, subtracted by, I'll use the subtract R0 comma R0 comma hash 1. Okay, so how many times you have to subtract it? Suppose that till R0 becomes 0, total passes become 0, so we should affect your flag bits. Okay, then only we can say check that whether it is equal to 0 or not. If it is equal to 0, nothing but branch if equal, then you have to stop your execution. Okay, so the main basic work is that if only one number, if your count is only 1, so no need of sorting. Okay, that is the main reason also. And we need crepitation. We need to something control over that. Otherwise, your program go in infinite loop. Okay. So one control is with the help of R0. It'll keep the count of how many passes are required. Okay. Now I'll copy this content of R0 to R1 to for inner iteration. Okay. For comparison, so I'll use the move R1 comma R0. So content of R0 is copied in the R1. Okay. Now no problem. Okay. Now next, I'll take the pointer which holds the address of the element. As I said, the R2. So LDR R2 comma your array name is series. Okay. Now this is held by your pointer. Okay. Now how we can repeat this one now? Okay. Now we got the address of first element. Now we need the address of second element. Now we'll go to this next example. Here 5 and 1. We got the address of 5. Now we need the address of 1. Okay. We need the address of 1. So address of 5 hold by the R2. We need the address of 1 also. Now next element. So for that, what I have to write it? For that, you have to write. First, we'll get those number in different register. It's better. We can, and even you can do comparison. So copy the first element in R3, comma in square bracket R2. First number 5 is copied into the R3. Okay. So I'll write in come here. I'll copy this. We'll come to know that. Let's assume that we are working with these numbers. Okay, let's assume that all these are 32-bit numbers. Okay. So you got the address of 5. As I already have said that in the RAM manually you have to enter these numbers. Okay, here we can't declare it because your Kyle compiler does not able to read that one. Okay. Now the first number element is copied in R3. Next LDR next number will copy in R4. So for that, as I said that, we have to add 4 into that. Okay. So nothing but the first number you are copied in R3, second number you are copied in R4. Okay. Now copying that, loading that number from the memory with the help of load instruction. Now we need to compare content of R3 with the R4. Keep in mind that we need to where the first element you have copied and where second element of copy, because based on that we can able to swap it and take the decision. Okay. Now I'll use the compare R3 with the R4. So in compare instruction, we'll compare R3 with the R4. Now R3 you are comparing with the R4 to check that whether R3 is less than R4 or not. That's only we're going to check it. Okay, if it is less than, then no need to swap it or interchange it. Okay, if greater than, of course we need to swap it. Okay, so for that I'll use the BLO branch if low. So I'll use the label name next. So meaning of next BLO means if content of R3 is lower than R4, go to the label name next. Nothing but go and check the next two elements. Okay, that is 1 and 4 here. Okay. Now, if the condition fails, nothing but R3 is not below the R4. Of course, we need to interchange the content of these two. We need to interchange. Nothing but whatever content in R4, whatever content in R4 that we need to copy at memory pointed by R2, whatever content in R3 that we need to copy to memory pointed by R2 plus 4. Nothing but next memory location. How we can do this one? By using your store instruction. Okay. So I'm right here, it's better. So this I have to copy it here, and this I have to copy it here. Okay. So I'm right here. STR. Now we are storing in the memory. Keep in mind that we are not loading in the register. Already numbers are there. Only you need to store it in different addresses. Okay. R3, we have to store it at R2 comma hash 4, then str R4 we have to keep it in the Oh, sorry, this R2, sorry, R2, it is R2 and this is R2. Okay, now you can clear, carefully observe that these two line. You can observe that here. Here you can observe that content of R3 we are copied in R2 comma hash 4. Here it is, we have copied it. Here we have copied this part, we have carried here. In content of R4 we have copied into the content of memory pointed by R2. This point is here. Nothing but we have swapped it with the help of store instruction. Okay. If they are not in order, then we'll let it swap it. Otherwise, go and check the next number. After swapping also, go and check the next two elements also. Even though without swapping also, go and check the next two elements. So how we can do that one for that? Okay. To check next element. So of course, already the R2 is pointing at first element. We can observe that. Yeah, here the R2 is pointing at first element. Okay. So now we need to increment pointer and point to the next element. It is 1. Okay. But after swapping, it becomes now this is 1 and this is 5. Okay. 2, 8. Okay. After swapping, it become 1 and it can. Now nothing but we need to increment the pointer with point to the 5 now. Okay, nothing but second element, address of the second element. To do that, and write here add R4 comma R, oh sorry, I am using pointer R2 comma hash 4, done. Okay, so you have to write here your label name next. Now you got the meaning of next now. Nothing but with swapping or without swapping, after that we have to go and check the next two elements. So we need to increment the pointer. Now after incrementing, now next work is that now whether how many comparison are done. Now you compared only first two elements. Okay. You are compared only first two element, these two are compared. I will need to compare these two and these two. So total of many comparison, 4 comparison. So one comparison I done it, nothing but our remaining 3 comparisons are. So one need one counter which can keep the track of comparison. So we can keep that one. Same thing again, subtract, yes, I'll use it. R1, hash 1, because R1 I am using to keep the track of your comparison. R0 I am using to keep the track of number of passes. Okay. If it is 0, then stop your comparison. If it is not 0, then repeat the process. So I have to write branch if not equal, then go to after what label name I have to write now, again I have to write or repeat I have to write. And write again. Okay. So where I have to write this again label now? In front of new load or in front of direct like in comparison? Where I have to write? You have to write here load because you already have an address of the pointer, you are incremented. Again, if you point to the series, it will come back to point to again to first element. Now pointer should start from comparison from the second element. So that's why I will start with the here load R3 comma square bracket R2 will start the again. Okay, this is label name. Make it more, arrange it properly. Now I will repeat this process till R1 becomes 0. Nothing but I will compare all these numbers which is in the array. We'll compare it to after point incrementing R2 to each element. After comparing all these, I cannot repeat this. Now I have completed one pass. Now I repeat this repetition. So we'll go for second pass. Okay. To go to second pass, so we need to check that how many pass you have completed. So that is done by your register R0 will keep the track of number of pass. So after this branch, if not equal, then we have to go and check, subtract the R0 by 1. What you have written here. So you can use the unconditional branch instruction. Okay, you can't write again and again here also subtract R0, R0, #1. So repeatedly, unnecessary repeatedly, you're going to write it. So you can write. Okay, so I'll write here repeat. I'll use that in front of. Subtract. Okay, now one comparison we have done it, sorry, one pass we have done it. Initially R0 is 4, now it become 3. Okay, so it will repeat this process till when? Till R0 becomes 0. Nothing but you have done all the passes, okay, or all the comparison after compare, repetitive comparison, we have sorted all the numbers. So this is the way the program is written. Now I'll execute this one. I'll save this one. Okay, sorry, I'll save all. Okay, there is no error or warning. Build, rebuild. So there is no error or warning here also in during building also. Now I'll debug this one. Now here in debug we need to work in on RAM now. Connected. We need to work on RAM. Okay. Now in RAM, ROM already the number is available, your count is already stored here, 5. On which address? 6, I think. 6, no, not 6, sorry, not 6. Where 5000 is stored in that here. It is stored at 3. Oh, sorry. The window is not arranging. Okay, here it is stored. At 40, 5, how many zeros are? 6 zeros are, meaning that you are using 32-bit numbers. Okay. Now before start execution, your RAM always start at location 4, 6 zeros. So first store all the numbers. So what number you are using it? That is, I'm using, okay, I'll write here, 51428. So in the first one I'll write 5, next 32-bit number is 1. Keep in mind that I'm keeping the gap storing in each successive 4 memory location because you are working with 32-bit numbers. Then 4, then 2, then 8. Okay, so all these 5 numbers I have stored here. These are my 5 numbers I store. All these are my 32-bit numbers. Okay, now we need to arrange it or sort it in ascending order. Okay, so I'll go for step by execution. Okay, please observe that R0 is 5 initially, now subtract it by 1. I'll check that whether it is 0 or not, so it's not 0. So it'll same thing will copy into the R1 also. Then R2 will load the address of your array. R2 is held by the array. Then R3 will bring the first element. So first element is copied. Then R4 will bring the second element with the help of load. 5 and 1 you have copied. Okay, 1 is here. Then we'll compare it. Yes, compare. Then branch if lower to check your, you can check the CPSR. When after the carry flag is set, nothing but the R35 is not lower than the R4. So we need to swap or interchange it. Now carefully observe that how it will BLO will work. Then we'll go to the store. This condition get failed. It will swap it. Now look at here, here it is 5 and here this is 5 and this is 1. After swapping, this first element become 1 and second element become 5. Now 5, second element, now first element become 1. Okay, interchanged. Okay. Now we will increment the pointer R2 to point the next element, that is 4604. Okay. Now it will point, compare, now it will compare 5 with the 4 now. Now it become R1 become 3 because one comparison are done. Then we'll reload the values R3 and R4. R3 is 5 it's loaded and R1 it loaded, R1 I load it now. R1 it become 4 now. Okay. R3 is loaded with 5, R1 is 4. Now as I said, that will compare 5 and 4. Again, we'll compare that. Again, we can interchange it. We can observe that 5 and 4 get interchanged. Here, 5 and 4 get interchanged. Then again, pointer should point to the next element. I can observe that it pointing and remove all these. Okay. Now we can observe that it will now compare pointing to this element. Now I'm comparing 5 and now R1 become 2 because 2 comparison over, now 2 comparison remaining, 5 and 2 is remaining and 2 and 8 is remaining. Okay, nothing but 3 element comparison is required remaining. Okay. Now we're comparing 5 with the 2, so of course we need the swap, so elements get swapped. Carefully observe that. I'll compare 5 with 8, so no need of this one. The swapping, we can observe that it jump from BLO to directory to the next. Now R2 will point to the next address, but R1 till becomes 0, it's nothing but one pass we have completed. Now go for next pass. That is subtract R0 by 1, so it become, right now it is 4, now it become 3. Now 3 passes are remaining. Okay, so we can keep on, I'll press keep on step by step. Slowly we can observe that content of each register and how they are interchanged on when it is not interchanged. Okay, nothing but swapped or not swapped if they are not in order, or we can keep observing these numbers. We'll come to know that. Okay. Can observe that they are interchanging. The 4 and 2 is remaining interchange. Now you can observe that 4 and 2 is interchange. No, there is no further interchange. Now keep on looking at content of R1 also and R2 also, R0 and R2 also. Okay. When R0 has become 0, so it will stop your execution. Nothing but you are, all numbers are sorted. You can observe that after sorting it become 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, correctly in ascending order. Okay. Even you can work with the 32 bit number also. I'll restart this one. So all are become 0, all register content. Now I'll change to 32 bit numbers, like example 55. I'll take a 32 bit number and these number I have to arrange it in the ascending order. In writing, whenever I start writing the output in journal, so you mention the numbers before execution, what number you are given, after execution how the numbers are sorted. Okay, first you give the number in a random numbers, then after sorting, then after output header it sorted numbers. Okay. Of course, there is no change in the count. Okay. But as you can change the count, you can change, I am using 5 elements, you can make any other number of elements. You can take less than or more than 5 elements also. Okay. Now these are my inputs I have given it. Now considering this is the worst condition. So I need to arrange this in ascending order. Okay. So I'll directly run this one. I'll stop it. You can observe that all numbers are sorted. 1, 1, 8 ones, 2, 2 8s, 3 8s, 4 8s, 5 8s. Okay. Now this is an arranging ascending order. Okay. To arrange it in descending order. So what changes you have to do? How do you know that in large, finding the largest and smallest number, what we have done? Okay. In smallest number you wrote BLO. For smallest, largest number you wrote BHI. Similarly here for ascending order I wrote BLO. So descending order write only BHI. Okay, now I'll stop this one. I'll change it to BHI. Save, translate, build, rebuild, then debug. Now I'll enter some numbers which I want to arrange it in the descending order. So I'll give the inputs are in ascending order, so it will arrange it in descending order. Just double click on it, enter your numbers. Okay, it will store it into that each memory location. Now all 5 numbers are entered here. Now directly I'll run this one and stop it. I can observe that all numbers are arranged in descending. Okay. Initially all are 8 ones, 2 ones, 2 8 ones, 3 8 ones, 4 8 ones, 5 8 ones. Okay. So now arrange better 5 8s, 4 8s, 3 8s, 2 8s, 1 8s. Okay. In ascending order also you can arrange in descending order. To write output in journal, so you should mention like this also, you have to mention it and come out. So these are your input and this is your output. So in output you need to mention that these are input, nothing but this we have to write, these are input. Not right. And write your output. I am saying that writing in journal, not in the program. Okay. And showing it how to write in journal. This part you have to write in journal. Okay. So instead of writing space, you have to mention like this also. DCD 5 elements, then after arranging these numbers are become like 1, 2, 4 and this is 5, 8. Okay, this is your, this we have to write in journal. Okay. In journal you have to write this. Okay, you can change the count, you can change any numbers also, you can use 32 bit number, 8 bit number, 16 bit number also. The same method is applicable here. Okay, same thing will get. Okay. Okay, fine. So in next session we'll look at into the next experiment, that is your last part in part A, 8th experiment, that is write program to count number of ones and zeros in two consecutive memory locations. Okay. Okay. So next part we'll discuss the 8th program. Thank you.